Greetings, friends. A wonderful new feature called Variance has been added into the Point Color panel in Lightroom and Lightroom Classic. Variance is a color contrast control that adjusts the distance between a chosen hue and its surrounding colors. The Variance slider itself is pretty straightforward, but a thorough grasp of Lightroom's Point Color and masking tools are needed before you can effectively utilize this new option. I'm going to assume that you already have this type of essential background knowledge throughout this tutorial. So if you're ready, then let's jump in and let's get started. Here, we have five shades of blue that are all neighbors on the color wheel. If I open up Lightroom Classic's Color Mixer panel and switch over to the Point Color tool, then you can see the new Variant slider down at the bottom. For this demo, I'm going to activate the Point Color Eyedropper tool, and then I will click to set a sample point right in the middle. If I pull the Variant slider to the left, if I pull it towards a negative value, then I'm telling Lightroom that I want it to adjust all of the other colors so they become closer to the hue that I just sampled. If I pull this all the way down to negative 100, then we get an almost uniform shade of blue all the way across my diagram. I'm going to reset this control with a double tap. If I push the variance to the right, then I'm creating more color contrast. The hues that neighbor my target are being pushed further and further away from the color that I originally sampled. If I take this all the way to plus 100, then the rectangle on the far left has become a cyan, and the one on the right a magenta. For those of you with some background knowledge of color theory, this should make sense, since blue neighbors cyan and magenta on our color wheel. Now that you know what this tool does, let me show you three examples where I find this new feature incredibly helpful. The first two examples that I'm going to work on are fall landscape shots, and the last one will be a portrait. In my opinion, autumn is the most rewarding season for landscape photography, but getting strong fall foliage photos is not easy. Often, my fall scenes feel underwhelming because there is too much uniformity of color. In this image, for example, there is little difference between one shade of yellow leaf and another. To fix that, I'm going to activate the Point Color Sampler tool, and then I'm going to select a spot where the leaves are a pleasing shade of yellow. It takes a little getting used to, but when you use Variant, select a color that you would like to keep rather than sampling one that you want to change. When I drag the Variant slider up, I am pushing all of the other hues away from the spot that I just sampled. If I push this all the way to plus 100, then some of the affected colors are driven all the way to red and to green, since those are yellow's neighbors on the color wheel. Plus 100 looks a little overdone, so I'm going to back the variance adjustment down a little, and in no time, my image has a broader, richer, more complex range of hues. The additional color contrast gives this image a lot more punch, and since this is happening inside of the Point Color panel, I can also adjust the range to include or exclude additional hues. At this point, I feel like some of the green hues look oversaturated. To fix that, I'm going to open up the extended range controls, and then I'll turn on the visualize range option at the bottom of this panel. Quick point color review. When visualize range is active, Lightroom keeps the colors that this change will affect visible, and it turns all of the hues that will be unaffected by this command into shades of gray. Now, I can drag the hue range box to the left so that I'm targeting more of the red colors of this image and less of the greens. With a little adjustment to the spillover tick mark as well, I can set things up so that the green moss along that old stone wall is no longer affected by this variance command. Let me split my screen so that you can see a before and after comparison. On the left is my original image, and on the right is the much livelier, much higher color contrast result. I love the way that this scene looks now, so let's move on to another fall foliage photo where I can demonstrate the opposite effect. Here we have a photo that I shot in Glacier National Park. Unlike the last image, with its rich mix of deciduous trees and colorful leaves, this scene is dominated by one color in my part of Montana. Only our larch trees turn yellow, so there's no need for additional color contrast in this scene's fall foliage. Also, unlike the last image, there are colors in the sky here that are very similar to the hues in those trees. If I were to repeat the process that I followed last time, then my global variance changes would adversely impact some of those beautiful pink and gold clouds. I don't want that, so for additional precision, I'm going to use a right click and delete this swatch. Rather than using point color as a global command, I'm going to start in the masking panel. There are many ways that I can make a mask that isolates the foreground, but my favorite method is to utilize Lightroom's amazing new AI landscape object mask commands. Once I have the right mask, then I can scroll down to the point color section within the masking panel and activate the color sampler tool. Like last time, I'll pick a representative yellow, but this time I'm going to drag the variance slider down rather than up. Choosing a negative variance makes all of the yellow hues more uniform, and that gives this image a cleaner, more harmonious look. Next, I want these trees to have more impact, so to make them pop, I'll add some saturation and a small shift to the luminance. Now, I can check my mask and adjust the amount slider for this masking layer if needed. As you can see, this change has brought more color harmony and impact into my foreground. Let's finish things off with a completely different type of photograph and a different use for the new variance feature. One of the most common challenges when shooting headshots are uneven skin tones. This gentleman, for example, has a lot of red pigment in his face. There are many ways to deal with this problem in Lightroom or Photoshop, but none of them are as easy as what we can do now using the variant slider. To smooth out his skin tones, I'm going to start with a portrait retouching mask that isolates his face and neck. Since I want one mask that targets both his facial skin and his neck skin, I want to make sure that I don't have the create two separate masks option ticked at this point. Once I have my mask, I can activate the point color eyedropper tool again and choose a skin tone that I like. For this trick to work, remember that you need to sample a color that you want to keep, not the one you want to remove when making your selection. Now, as I lower the variance, I'm moving all of the hues in his skin towards the color that I selected. At about negative 70, the redness is barely visible, and his face has a much more uniform skin tone. The redness is gone, but his face looks a little pale and lifeless. To fix that, I'm going to adjust the hue, saturation, and luminance controls. This looks great, so let me close the masking panel and show you a complete before and after. Wow, if you've ever tried to do this kind of headshot retouching work before, then I bet you're bouncing off the walls with joy. This was super easy, and we went from this to this in no time. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.